Bare Bone Bay is located 15 kilometers or 9.5 miles from Myrtle Beach in South Carolina. This is an area where the Carolina Bays with their well-defined sandy rims are clearly visible from the air. Welcome to another edition of the Carolina Bay of the Day, where we study the secondary impacts made by the glacier ice boulders that were ejected by an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide Ice Sheet. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool for Google Earth by Michael Davies in the description of the video. Bare Bone Bay is one of those elliptical structures that sparked debate about the Carolina Bays when they were first photographed from the air in the 1930s. The eastern part of the thick sandy rim of Bare Bone Bay is overlaid by another bay. This image was published in Melton and Shriver's 1933 publication with the title, "The Carolina Bays, Are They Meteorite Scars?" The topographic map from the U.S. Geological Survey labels the bay in a large area to its west as Bare Bone Bay. The USGS gave names to areas that seem to have similar characteristics rather than to just the particular elliptical geological features. This map also has some streams labeled as bays, which means that at the time that the map was made, the concept of Carolina Bay was not well defined. This USGS map also shows extensive mottled blue areas marked as swamps that include many Carolina Bays. The terrain has an average elevation of 16 meters above sea level, and the water table is very close to the surface. The swampy areas were a breeding ground for mosquitoes, and malaria was endemic in the United States. The first known case of malaria in America is believed to be after the arrival of explorer Christopher Columbus in 1492. Malaria propagated in America as the colonization by Europeans increased, and by 1607, the disease had established itself and became epidemic in the Jamestown settlement. Malaria was eliminated in the United States in the 1950s by the use of insecticides such as DDT, which was banned in 1972 because it was also killing pollinating insects, and it caused the decline of bald eagles by making their eggs more fragile. Mosquito populations were also reduced by digging ditches and draining the swampy areas where the mosquitoes bred. Carolina Bays are swampy because the water table is usually within 5 feet of the surface. Draining the bays makes the land available for cultivation of crops and for urban development. Bare Bone Bay has a draining trench leading to where they stream to its west. This particular landscape has many examples of overlapping bays, which are evidence of multiple impacts by the glacier ice boulders that were in the ejecta curtain of an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide Ice Sheet. We will discuss some of these in detail. Here we see two cases of a 1-2 punch. The first impact makes a bay with a broad rim, and then a second impact adjacent to the first one overlays a portion of the first rim. The second impact makes a crescent-shaped indentation in the first rim. There are also bays that completely overlap each other. This happens when the ballistic trajectories of the ice projectiles have a slightly different launch angles, but the same range. The first impact creates an inclined conical cavity that produces a prominent rim in the direction that the projectile was traveling. The second projectile falls within the area of the first one and makes a second rim. In this case, the two impacts overlap the rim of Bare Bone Bay. This is probably why the rim does not look like a neat crescent. Here is an example of three adjacent impacts. Bay number 2 was made after bay number 1, as evidenced by the way in which it overlapped rim number 1. Bay number 3 was formed on top of bay number 1. For this example, one could argue that bays 1 and 3 were made before bay number 2 because there is no evidence that bay number 3 overlaid number 2. That is possible. There are many mysteries about the Carolina Bays that will always remain unsolved. The pictures of adjacent experimental impacts illustrate the mechanism by which overlapping bays are created. Viscous relaxation reduces the depth of the inclined conical cavities and creates the overlapping shallow elliptical bays. Old State Highway 90 goes along the rim of Bare Bone Bay. When I first went exploring the Carolina Bays in 2014, I remember thinking, how convenient! With these roads, it should be very easy to explore the Carolina Bays. The reality was very different. Old State Highway 90 is just a sandy road that gets very muddy and slippery after a rain. If you're going to explore the Carolina Bays, you better take a four-wheel drive vehicle. Also, you will find that many of the roads by the bays are marked as private property or blocked with chains, cables, and no trespassing signs. Barebone Bay is located 1,185 kilometers from Saginaw Bay, which is assumed to be the point from which the ice boulder that made the bay was launched. The bay has a width of 780 meters and a length of 1,216 meters. The width-to-length ratio corresponds to an impact angle of 39.9 degrees. The diameter of the glacier ice projectile that made the bay is estimated to be 243 meters, which is one-fifth of the bay length, or about the size of the Rose Bowl Stadium. The ballistic equations indicate that the glacier ice boulder that made this bay was launched at a speed of 3.437 kilometers per second. It had a flight time of 7.49 minutes and reached a height of 247 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. The trajectory was a suborbital spaceflight in the vacuum of space. The kinetic energy of the impact that made Barebone Bay was equivalent to 9.73 megatons of TNT, which would have caused seismic vibrations of magnitude 8.14. When you explore the Carolina Bays on foot, there is not much to see. There are some patches of sand which form the rims of the bays, and the centers are covered with muddy, insect-infested, impenetrable brush. There is nothing breathtaking like the rocky slopes of a mountain or the thunderous roar of a waterfall. This ordinary appearance is probably why geologists have not been interested in studying the Carolina Bays. However, the LiDAR images of the bays give us a spine-chilling perspective of a horrific extinction event in the Earth's recent past, and that is very exciting. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. I will continue to examine the Carolina Bays one bay at a time. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays.